Happy holidays, Gundam fans, and on day 6, we're going to be looking at the 160 scale Neilson Works Astray. I figured I'd just group them all into one. Just showing the grape frame on the turntail because, well, you can't really fit any more than one. But I do want to show together with the blue frame because there's actually technically 5 variants of this kit going around. You got the original red frame, which came with the katana, beam rifle, shield, and then I think the ghost frame was next, which is it's a gray version, which had a different head. It had, I believe it was 6 katanas and the flight pack included. And then you had the, I think the green frame was next, which had the same head, I think, as the other one, the gray one, came with the backpack. And I don't think it came with as many katanas. Now, I've given it the beam axe, beam saber thing from the blue frame because it's supposed to have that. But it came with the blue frame from Deban. Anyways, then we have this one, which is my favorite, the blue frame, because it has everything that the metal build version has, but they're all blown up and like heavily modified as well. And then you have the red frame again, which basically came with everything I think the ghost frame had, because the original red frame did not come with the backpack. And then there was supposed to be a gold frame. It never happened. I wish it did. But anyway, so we have about 5, I think. And they're all basically, as far as I can tell, the master grade, blown up and heavily modified. Like, there are similar building experiences in this kit compared to the master grade, but they really, really modified the hell out of it. And I think these look perfect for a 160 scale Astray compared to the Bandai Perfect Grade, which I feel is way too bulky for an Astray, personally. And they're all pretty good. They have some things that have to be glued here and there. My biggest problem with all these kits are the hands, because they have the cool, fully posable fingers, but if you notice, there's a... Oops, if I can get the camera to work. There is no peg inside the palms, which means they're holding all of their accessories with friction, except for the blue frame. They actually give you these mounting brackets that peg into the back of the arms, which are holding the bazookas. The hands aren't doing it, it's the arms. And that was a brilliant idea. I wish they had done something with the other ones. I don't know how they could have done it for the katanas. But a simple peg and hole would have been so much better. And also the wrists are a little loose pegging into the arm, which doesn't help. And also the fact that they're all being piloted by little petite guys inside the cockpit, it's kind of cool. So, yeah, these are all very good. And if you had to pick one, I would say get the blue frame, just because, like I said, well, first, it has the most unique weapons, and you can actually have them hold them in the hands, where the other ones really can't. Unless you kind of, like, get them wedged in there really well, maybe underneath the arm, underneath the armpit. But, yeah, he's holding that on just by friction. He had pretty tight hands, but, and this isn't very heavy. So yeah, it was a pretty cool, I guess you could say, line of kits, even though they're basically the same. So that's about it, and I'll see you in day 7.